I have spina bifida. It's something to do with your spine. It's a birth defect, and I've never really researched what it is or what it does, just because, you know, I just don't really focus on that. I've been in a wheelchair my whole life, and when I was about 8, my brother, you know, he was into BMX at the time, and I would go to the skate park and just watch him ride his bike, and then he told me, he's like, you should try it on that wheelchair. And I was like, I haven't even thought about that. So, you know, him and his friends helped me get my chair to the top of, you know, a 4-foot quarter. And then they're like, you know, peer pressure settled in, and I dropped in and, you know, pretty much just fell on my wrists at first, because I didn't know you had to do a manual into it. But after a couple drop-ins, I got it. And then right there, I was hooked on it, you know. Then I'd started, you know, working my way up through the ramps. I'd drop in a bigger ramp. And then after I'd conquer a skate park and have done every tall drop in there, then my older brother would tell me about another park that has bigger drop-ins, you know. A big influence on me was BMX, because it's what my brother did and what got me into it. And I have big wheels like a biker. So my first real trick was a 180 off of a box jump. And that took me forever, just to get that rotation, you know, throwing your head and stuff. And after I did that, that was cool, but I got bored. I was like, that's cool, but that's boring. I need something else. Then a bunch of bikers and stuff were like, you know, it'd be cool if you could backflip on a wheelchair. And I was like, that would be pretty sick. You know, I've never even thought about that. I heard people on chairs were trying backflips into foam, but none of them were getting the rotation. And in my mind, I was just like, how do you not do that? You know, just grab here and pull back. And so that's a week-long camp. Within the second day, I landed the backflip, the first backflip on a wheelchair, and I was stoked about that. You know, called up mom, and she didn't really believe it until I showed her the footage. But, you know, it was sick. I was stoked.
That's sick, dude.
Well, wheels came about. It started off in middle school. I always go around, you know, doing little tricks to impress the girls and stuff, and just, you know, always in a wheelie and jumping stairs. You know, just all the kids started calling me Wheelies because I was always in a wheelie, and then it just transformed into wheels, and it's just what I've been called most of my life, you know, from middle school up. And I actually respond to wheels faster than Aaron, because it's just, I'm used to wheels. You know, thousands of people are named Aaron, but there's very few wheelsers. You know, I was doing flips for a couple of years, and I was like, I gotta get a hand plant, because that's just something I've always loved. And that took longer. That took a month of a lot of crashes to land a hand plant. But you know, finally got that, and I was stoked on that. The hardest part about riding this park is there's no ADA accessible entrance. That means there's no way for a wheelchair to get easily in and out. Well, in, yes, out, no. So this is the best way I've found to get out of this bowl. You know, then watching X Games, I see something called the Mega Ramp, and I'm like, that's sick. You know, like, that's one of the coolest things I've ever seen. So I was like, you know, I need to get on there somehow. And then one night, I'm checking the feedback from my website, and I had an email, and it was from Nitro Circus, and you know, they've pretty much said, we heard from Travis that you were doing flips and you were kind of looking for something like this. And I was like, I freaked out. I was like, Nitro Circus and a big ramp? So I went in and woke my parents up, had them come read the email. I was so stoked. Before I knew it, I found myself at practice for the Nitro Live Tour. It was cool. It gets me too pumped. Like, I'm not scared to go down the ramp because of all the people. I think I get overly pumped. Like, I use that crowd's energy too much sometimes. And I have to tell myself to calm down, or I'll end up doing like a triple backflip when I'm going for a single, you know? Just gotta relax and breathe, you know? this whole experience so far with Nitro and all, everything that's happening in my life right now, it feels like a dream. Like right now, I think I'm just like, you know, I think I just got a concussion and this is all going on in my head. I'm just scared to wake up, you know? Like, I don't want to wake up and be laying out in the skate park, you know? Because this is more than I could ever dream of. Things have happened that I never thought would happen.